up against Tibbs.
Yes. So
I love Tibbs. He's one of my new favorite players.
Tibbs is super dope, like, both as a person, but as a player. He's not ultra campy as a Pac-Man, like most people would consider Pac-Man to be. Obviously, he doesn't, you know, hang back and throw projectiles, but he doesn't only do that.
Yeah.
And Ness, obviously, the stream monster, as well as top 10 in the world. So.
Yeah.
That's where this goes.
Freaking Austin. He's just insane. This man has still figured out how to be as crazy as in every other game. Look at this.
How did that
kind
hit?
Of.
Okay.
Honestly, yeah, the fight to that fire hitbox was still going. I sort of swore that maybe it hit the fire and kept going.
Yeah, maybe.
That makes sense.
Because, yeah, that second one was definitely super below.
Yeah,
Pac-Man,
it really
so should have
just went through it, but I guess it hit the fire hitbox that was already out. That makes sense. All right, but he's like Austin, already with a lot of control. Tibbs not having a chance to set up that normal Pac-Man Hydrant into what projectile can I throw?
Basically. I mean, he's just still stuck with pretty much only cherries, and then if he gets anything else, it's not at a time where he needs anything else. Up smash on the ledge, not going to kill.
I love that Austin's using that now. He saw Best Ness use it, and he was just like, wow, I should be using this. Wow, that's sick. Austin's learning so much.
Really is.
His brain's getting bigger.
We don't need to be bigger. He is already too good.
His brain's already too big. He's trying to tip for that. That would have been a great Asgardian tool, but he didn't get the chance.
Wow.
Oh, got Bell. Oh, my God,
that will
Tibbs.
Do it.
Holy crap.
Pac-Man's actually cool in this game. Up smash still going to take it, though.
Holy crap. That setup was legit.
Yeah, no. Pac-Man can actually do some really, really sick stuff with that side B in this game. It can kill relatively early. So it's really interesting to see what he can do with it. Obviously, the up air to up tilt combos are what Austin's been working on as of late, is what he was telling me.
What I love more than the fact that killed, right, is that, like, even when he was in such a deficit, so much control in Austin's favor, he still found the opening to connect and get that confirmed, right? That was crazy. Like, most players, when they're playing against someone who is just tossing them around the first stock, they don't really find those moments to capitalize and get back in the game. And he found the perfect moment to get the lead.
Yeah, and it also required a little bit of stuff. So he had to find time while he was being pressured to find that little bit of space that he needed to set it up.
Yeah.
But that's a big Austin no-brainer right there.
Yeah, right. If he had gone to the platform, I think he would have been fine. But because he had used that move and he had the ending lag there, Austin was ready. He's always ready to try to go for the PK too.
Yep. He throws out that PK Thunder offstage. Mostly as an edge guard, but also, you know,
did it?
If you get away from him, he's able to throw it out on himself. That screen in the back is still weird to me. I still have not gotten used to it. Oh my gosh!
I tried not to notice it, but yeah, I love that. He set up the bell to where the water would blow it right into Austin after the back air. Let him set up. And that's what he's been getting a lot of his kills off of, is that bell. Austin needs to be wary of when that bell comes out from Tibbs. Pac-Man grab. What is that? I've never seen that before.
This is a last stock situation. So we're going to see who can clutch up. If we're going to see Austin taking game number one, or Tibbs will be able to find his way back into this one like he did in the first stock.
I'm not going to lie. Tibbs is playing this and he's really keeping this super competitive as well. Oh, took off the stage. Now, Austin is really good at having those offstage edge guards, but what a forward air there. I didn't actually know that could get rid of the ball of the PK Thunder. Oh, that's
this?
Big.
Oh.
Yeah, he's got the bell out. Like I said, Austin needs to watch out for the
bell.
Oh, my God! That's
gosh!
It! That's the setup he did last time, right? He had the fire hydrant shoot out the bell to set up into that last stock he got. But I think Austin knew that was coming. I don't think he realized how fast that bell was going to shoot forward.
Yeah.
Even I was just like, what the? That thing flew.
He jumped down like he was going to try to bat it away or something. But then it came at the speed of light.
Yeah.
And Austin blinked and
was
stunned.
That was one of those, I've never seen this before, right? That,
yes.
That was one of those unfamiliarity moments. Tibbs is a god, by the way.
Yeah, Tibbs is super high IQ. He's super homie.
Tibbs has the biggest brain, but that's also like, you had to watch out for that bell, but even more so because of how it can interact with that Hydra, right? That was, honestly, that looked unreactable. I don't think you could wait for that bell and try to react to that with the bat.
No way.
And it's not an energy projectile either. Wow, look at these Galaga combos. What? Well, it was looking like a really in control Austin set. Like, he's just going to take another 2-0, move on to grand finals. Tibbs is looking to take out Austin. Already has one game over him. Already in so much control.
Oh my goodness.
Bell
this
in hand. Damage piling up. Bell.
Yeah, there's no way you can react F smash to that unless you have the F smash charging.
You legitimately,
as soon as he has the platform down.
I will argue that is unreactable. I don't think you can react to that at all. That is just like you just get away from that thing. It's going to fly at you. Wow, he actually got out of the fire immediately through the hydrant, catches him there. And now, look, a really solid commanding lead here from Tibbs. And he's one game up right now over Austin.
Yeah, who just beat SDX this weekend, by the way.
Austin, who has not lost the Shockwave other than the one that Trella came to offhandedly.
Yes.
Taking it over MDV, or MBD, taking it over multiple times over our greatest players at Shockwave.
Tamim, Lima, MBD, SDX. He's beaten a bunch of the old top 50s. That would have been huge. Austin just trying to find a way to slobber knock his way back into this one. It's not going to work out there, though. That side B is way too strong.
Yeah, misspacing his back air there. Bell in hand for Tibbs. Austin quick to get it away, though. Not an opportunity to edge.
Oh, that was... Yeah. I feel like you should have just taken the safer bet there and gone for the second bounce.
I think he was expecting to just magnet hands there, and he was.
Yeah, no, for sure he was.
Yeah, I don't think he was. Oh wow, that actually, if that was a second earlier, that may have clipped Austin. But Austin off the stage now, throws out the orange, goes deep with the down air, finds another stock.
The side Tibbs is playing so well.
Look at the percent on Tibbs, low percent.
Yep.
We have Austin on his possible final stock here tonight in the winner's bracket. Guys, this, I don't even think this is top 32. This isn't even the top. We're not even out of pools yet, right?
Is this, no, this isn't bracket. This isn't bracket.
This isn't bracket?
No, it is.
Oh, so it is. Okay.
But this would be minimum 30-second upseeding first seed.
Wow.
Right, he did a loop-de-loop on him. If that would have hit,
Austin searching for an answer. Finds the back air. Fire Hydrant didn't land on the stage. Going to be picked up by the PK Thunder. Patience there.
Wow,
find
he
the
was going for
the
down smash.
Oh, yeah. Just got him. He knows he's going to be going for the hydrant. Austin reeling back. A sigh of relief that he hit that back air. Still in a huge deficit, though. The bell's out. Yeah, have to get rid. Yeah, he can't deal with that bell.
If he gets hit by bell, this is going to be a 2-0 set.
Yeah, so. Honestly, what he needs to do is make himself and put himself in such a state that we're... The bell isn't going to come out.
Also, that grab is actually good now. It doesn't. Okay. It's active for more than one frame. So... Yeah. Austin's now in the lead. This is clutch monster Austin.
Yeah, he's got a great setup here, but now we have a chance for him to start pulling the fruit. He started pulling the fruit, though.
Mm-hmm.
Be careful of Tibbs. Has the bell.
Oh, my God. Almost he backed it the first time. Austin has it, throws it away. That was smart.
Austin somehow grabbing that bell, throwing it off the stage. Can't let him pick up another one. Has Pear. Pear has a lot of knockback.
Yes, it does. Definitely going to be killing back throw. Not going to do the trick, but he's able to buy time.
Forcing Austin to respect him in the shield.
Oh,
throws
out
the key. Ooh, maybe an accident
the fast
there?
One. Definitely an accident. Wow, the down air beating out the S-Smash.
Okay. Oh, he did it! Making it Austin gets knocked into losers! Austin gets knocked into losers early by Tibbs.
That curved off the stage and killed him.
Wow.
I have never in my life seen it interact like that. That was disgusting. I thought he was going to go straight down, bounce off the stage, bounce up. And holy, that might be the first time Austin's been like upset in this caliber since Smash 4.